This video is about my plans to build an affordable, solar, seasonally heated greenhouse. I built a 200 square foot geodesic dome metal frame for about $130, and as I go forward, this is my vision for it. Several people have already done geo-air greenhouses on YouTube, LDSPrepper most notably, but no one's been able to get the inside temperature much over 2 to 5 degrees Celsius, just above freezing, with stored solar heat. I'm going to show how using a liquid instead of air can add about an extra 10 degrees Celsius, bringing the inside up to 12 to 15 degrees at night, so you can grow things like tomatoes and strawberries year-round in northern climates that get minus 30 degree temperatures. Simple Tech, technology, agriculture, and energy videos. Hitting the subscribe button tells YouTube these are the kind of videos you want to see more of. Click the subscribe button now. Okay. To get summer solar heat to use in the winter affordably, and I stress affordably, as anything can be done with unlimited money, it requires a few systems to all work together. First is insulation, in three ways. The first of those is a double inflated poly cover. Two sheets of greenhouse plastic are blown up like an inflatable Christmas yard decoration to give an R2 to R5 level of insulation, better than triple pane glass due to the thickness of the air gap. Next, because the sun rises low in the southern sky in the winter, the northern part of the greenhouse has styrofoam placed against the double air-filled poly for an additional R10 on half of the greenhouse. The third insulation is 2 inches of styrofoam placed under the floor for an R10 level of insulation from the ground. PEX tubing, which costs about $300 per 1,000 feet, is run above the floor styrofoam in concrete to create a radiant heat delivery system. Radiant heating is upwards of 30% more efficient than ducted air heat delivery systems. Of course, I'll pour my own concrete to save cash. First, it requires something called an evacuated tube solar collector. These devices can heat water to 80 degrees Celsius or higher. It works by connecting the PEX tubing and a small water pump heating the liquid circulating through the system when the sun is shining. That heated liquid is then transferred to a water container. The best container I could think of is an IBC container. You can find used ones on Kijiji or Craigslist for about $50 each. They hold about 250 gallons, enough heat stored in water to last several days to a week for a small greenhouse, and it takes about 3 to 4 days to heat it to maximum temperature capacity with a 30-tube collector. 3 to 4 days is great, but what happens if it's cloudy? Evacuative tubes still generate heat on cloudy days, but way less than a sunny day. You could run out of heat. Now here's where this gets interesting. Summer is obviously longer than 3 to 4 days. The IBC container is buried in the ground, and if we use the ground clay itself as a heat storage device, we can then heat all the material around the IBC container during the summer to act as an additional heat storage device. The ground around the container can be brought up to 40 to 50 degrees Celsius. By insulating the area above and below the IBC container, the heat storage of the ground will allow the water tank to keep providing heat to the greenhouse over extended periods throughout the winter. Heat moves so slowly through the ground that the ground will act as an insulator and heat sink for the water container. Radiant heat is delivered via PEX and a thermostat to the greenhouse at levels capable of heating the greenhouse to 15 degrees Celsius, even on the coldest nights. That's my plan. I'd love to hear your comments on if you think this is possible or not. Thank you for watching, and please take a moment to hit the subscribe button. Hitting subscribe tells YouTube to suggest to you more videos about technology, agriculture, and energy. Thanks for watching.